Good morning students, in the previous lecture we discussed about the moment of inertia, its physical significance, its dependence and SI unit and dimensions. In this lecture we are going to learn a new topic which is called as the rotational kinetic energy. We know that when a body performs linear motion in one direction, its kinetic energy is given by a simple relation 1/2 mv². Similarly, when the body rotated about the axis of rotation, what is the rotational kinetic energy of the body? In this section, we are going to discuss the formula of this rotational kinetic energy. Let's start. Consider a rigid body of any shape, and we know that this rigid body is made up of large number of particles having masses m1, m2, m3, and suppose the last is equal to mn, which are situated at a distance r1, r2, r3 from the axis of rotation. Consider the whole body is rotated with the angular velocity omega. It means the velocity, angular velocity of the whole body is constant, but the linear velocity of each particle will be different because the distance of this particle from the axis of rotation, they are different in each case. Therefore, in each case, the velocity is also different. Therefore, we can write the linear velocity v1, v2, v3 up to vn. Therefore, to calculate the rotational kinetic energy, we start from a linear kinetic energy. What is the formula for the linear kinetic energy? We know that it is equal to 1/2 mv². Therefore, for the first particle, we can write this linear kinetic energy as, this is kinetic energy for the first particle is equal to 1/2 m1 v1². It is simple. That is kinetic energy of a body of mass m is equal to 1/2 m1 v1². Now, in 11th class, we learned the relation between linear velocity and angular velocity. And this relation is like this, v is equal to r omega, where this v is the linear velocity and this omega is the angular velocity. Now, for the first particle, using this relation, for first particle we can write v1 is equal to r1 multiplied by omega. Why omega? Because the omega, that is angular velocity, for the whole body is constant. If we keep this value of v1 in this equation, therefore we can write here kinetic energy of the first particle is equal to 1/2 m1 r1 square omega square. Simple. Now, similarly, this kinetic energy for the second particle of mass m2, m3 and m1, we can calculate the kinetic energy in the similar way. Therefore, we can write kinetic energy of the second particle as, it is equal to 1/2 m2 r2 square omega square. Similarly, we can write kinetic energy for the nth particle, it is equal to 1/2 mn rn square into omega square. Now, if we have to calculate the total rotational kinetic energy of the body, we can add this kinetic energy of individual particles. Therefore, the rotational kinetic energy of the body, whole body, is equal to kinetic energy of the first plus kinetic energy of the second plus kinetic energy of the nth particle. Therefore, we can write here it is 1 by 2 m1 r1 square omega square plus 1 by 2 m2 r2 square omega square plus 1 by 2 ml rn square omega square. Now, from this we can take common 1 by 2, in bracket we can write m1 r1 square plus m2 r2 square plus mn rn square, and again omega square is common. It is equal to 1 by 2. This term in the bracket we can write in the form of summation, that is summation I equal to 1 to n mi ri square, and it is multiplied by omega square. Now, in the previous lecture we have seen that this term mi ri square is nothing but the moment of inertia of the body, and it is denoted by letter I. Therefore, we can write here 1 by 2 I omega square. Therefore, the rotational kinetic energy of the body is equal to 1 half I omega square. Now, if we see the linear kinetic energy is equal to 1 half mv square, and the rotational kinetic energy is equal to 1 half I omega square, these two relations are same, and we can say that the role played by the mass in the linear motion is similar to that the moment of inertia in the rotational motion. Okay, therefore this is the required equation for the rotational kinetic energy. Now, we can modify this equation. How? We know that this omega is equal to 2 pi n. What is the n? Small n is the number of rotations completed by this body in 1 second, that is called as the frequency. Therefore, we can write here kinetic energy is equal to 1 half I, here omega square, therefore what is omega square, it is equal to 4 pi square n square, which is equal to this. We can write here is equal to 2 pi square I into n square. Therefore, the rotational kinetic energy can also be calculated by using this formula. Here, we are using the frequency of the body. In the place of frequency, we can also write here the time period. What is time period? Time period is nothing but the time required to complete one rotation. Okay, now, we know what is time period, n is equal to 1 by t. Therefore, this equation we can also write kinetic energy is equal to 2 pi square I, and it is divided by t square. So, these are the different forms of the rotational kinetic energy. Here, we are going to stop. Goodbye. Have a nice day. Thank you.